So your ability to succeed is directly related to your ability to overcome massive challenges without freaking out and without paralyzing yourself. And today we're going to be looking at that from two different perspectives. And I think what you're going to see is that your business is never going to outgrow your mindset. So if you want to develop like a six-figure business for yourself, you're going to have to train your mind to be able to handle and overcome overwhelming challenges. And what you're going to find is that the more serious the challenge is, once you overcome it, the more impact the reward is going to have. So when you overcome serious challenges, what you're doing is you're building in monumental benefits for your life and for your business and for the types of things that you really want to be achieving. And so, so today we're going to look at that from two different perspectives. And I think by the time that you get through with this session here, you're going to come away with a pretty clear understanding of exactly what it's going to take to develop the business that you've really wanted, and not just the business that you want for yourself, but how you can actually reach out and do the same thing for your clients as well. So how can you overcome massive challenges for them and deliver the kind of results that they're really counting on you for? And of course, that's really what ultimately separates separates what we're doing here in this group from the traditional approach that most WordPress consultants, web designers are taking, especially the ones that are these kind of relatively low budget developers. So if you want to make that shift from only attracting kind of low budget clients to attracting high ticket clients, the very first thing that you need to do is change the way that you think about yourself, the way that you think about your work, your business, your clients. And of course, once you make that shift, it will also turn around and change the way your clients view you. It'll change the types of clients that you attract. And so what I can do to help with that, so when people come to work with me at DoubleStack, then you know I can make the entire process pretty simple. Like I can make it so that you cut out all of this wasted effort. I can help you double or triple or maybe even 10x your prices without pricing yourself out of the market. I can help you find better clients. I can help you do all of that stuff so that when you put energy into your business, that you're making an impact and you're making forward progress and you're not stalling out or even, you know, oftentimes making things worse. Those are things that I can do to help. I can make it really simple, but I can't make it very, nobody's going to be able to make it easy, if that makes sense. So what I mean by that is it takes effort, it takes work. And if you want to have a six-figure business, you're going to have to be able to deal with six-figure problems. And being able to overcome those challenges is a critical thing when it comes to running a business. So it's not just about your technical skills. It's not just about your business structure. Really, the engine behind the whole thing is you and your ability to recognize problems, overcome those problems, and then learn from the entire process in a way so that you're not repeating those same issues and you're actually being able to, you know, make a big difference in your life and in the lives of your clients. And so in order to do that, the first thing that you have to do is you have to take ownership of the problems. And, you know, I know that's a relatively common thing that people sometimes say in these kind of business development settings. But what I mean by taking ownership of the problem is all the types of problems. You know, there's some types of problems where it's easy to push off on, like maybe it's like your client's fault. It's like, you know, the reason that they didn't accept the proposal, or the reason that they're not getting the results, or the reason that they're not, you know, seeing the kind of results that they want with their website or whatever, it's their fault. You know, they're not creating the content. They're not doing their side. They're not willing to invest more, or they're not paying you enough to be able to, you know, do the work that you really need to be able to drive the results that they're looking for. And it's their fault. If they would just do something different, then the outcome would be different. And what I'm telling you is that's not a high value mindset. That's pushing it off. And what you need to do is you need to be able to take ownership of those issues. And the problem for most of the time, not all of the time, but most of the time, if your client is, it's not your client's fault for rejecting your proposal. Like if you make an offer and they say no, it's usually the offer's fault, or it's usually the way that you're going about connecting with the clients in the first place. It's not usually the client's fault. And so what I'm talking about when I say, you know, develop a six-figure business and develop a mindset that can support that is you have to take ownership of all of the problems. And the most serious problems that people in this group tend to have are either not having enough revenue coming in, not being able to connect with clients, or not even being able to attract the clients in the first place. And so the difference between connecting with clients is like onboarding clients to be your clients. And that's different from you just don't have access to, you just can't connect with the clients in the first place. So those tend to be like three of the really big problems. And we talked about how to overcome those in the previous session with a completely different approach to your business that causes those other issues to kind of go away. What I'm talking about today is a different kind of behind the scenes, like what's going on in your life that's causing these things to pop up. And what I'm suggesting that you do is take ownership of that, saying, hey, what can I do that's going to result in a different outcome when I go out and introduce, you know, what I can do to my clients? And so taking ownership of that, it means you look at the problem to see what's going on. And then you have to analyze, where are the issues? Like, what are the different problems that are kind of leading up to this outcome of some sort of undesirable result? And so think about it. It's like, is it your skill set? Like, do you need better tools in your toolbox to be able to drive better outcomes for your clients? You know, are they rejecting your proposals or not paying the rates that you expect them to pay or want them to pay, or the rates that you need to charge to be able to do your best result, because the technical skill set that you're offering is not quite there yet? Is that an issue? If so, we can talk about that. We can fix that. And let me show you a couple of technical concepts, of technical tools that drive business outcomes, that get more leads, get more calls, you know, get more repeat customers. How can you connect offline marketing efforts into online campaigns? Like, how do you make that connection? Like, if you meet somebody face to face, how do you kind of bring in the tools that you can deal with online in a way that causes that face to face interaction to be a more valuable and more impactful interaction? So maybe it's your technical skill set. That's something. So when you're looking at the problem, that is something to consider. Do you need better tech tools? Basically, do you need the tech stack? Do you need to ramp that up? Another point would be price point. Is the price point the problem? Do you have this low ticket offer and you're trying to put this high ticket price on it? Because if so, you're going to find that you're pricing yourself out of the market. You're going to find that people are saying, hey, it's too expensive. I can get the same kind of a thing for somewhere else, on Wix, on Upwork, on Fiverr, on Craigslist, or I can do it myself, whatever. And so if the solution that you're offering is actually a low ticket solution with a high ticket price, maybe that's the issue. It's not your client's fault if they can recognize a bad investment. That's a really important point to make. I'll say it again. It's not your client's fault for being able to recognize a bad investment. It's your fault for not presenting a stronger offer. And so what I'm saying is, if this is the kind of thing that you're trying to do, you're trying to onboard these high ticket clients where you're making $5,000 to $10,000 per month, and you have these recurring revenue generating packages that you're offering for you, so you have residual income coming in, and you've got these long-term relationships with your clients. You're not just client hopping, you know, kind of cranking out a website here and then moving on to the next client, but instead you're actually coming alongside your clients on a month-to-month basis, continuing to drive results. So you're building out their online presence and you're continuing to drive results from the work that you did on a month-to-month basis. That's the high value approach to WordPress consulting. And if that's what you're looking at, the price point could be an issue with that if that's not the offer that you're making, but you're putting that kind of a price tag on it. So look at that. Another would be the types of clients that you're approaching. And so, like, one of the things we talk a lot about here in this group is, I firmly believe that if you're out there trying to blog, if you're writing, you know, if you're doing content marketing, if you're trying to get social media to generate leads for you, and you're driving people to your website, and your website pretty much looks like a resume where you're talking about technical skills, like you know how to do SEO and content marketing and graphic design and branding and logos and website design and responsive design, like all the different things that you know how to do, if you find that you're using social media and blogging and whatever, these online tools to drive people to a website that's like that, hoping that you're going to be connecting with the kinds of clients that we were just talking about, where you're coming alongside and helping them on an ongoing basis to drive results for their business, you're going to be finding that that's not the right approach to connecting with clients. The types of clients you're going to find with that are people who are looking for stuff that's really cheap, that are like... kind of like one step away from do-it-yourselfers. Like, maybe they were people that were trying to do something themselves, found that it was a little bit more challenging or time-consuming or more difficult than they wanted. So they basically want the next best thing, which is somebody else to do it for as cheap as possible. and their mindset is in the wrong position, and they're never going to grow their business like that. And if they're not going to be coachable, if they're not going to be open to what you can offer, then that's not going to be the right kind of client. And so what I'm suggesting is stop blaming the clients for that. And instead, you know, look at what you're doing to cause those types of clients to come to you. What are you doing to attract that type of client? And what can you do to shift that into a better direction so you're actually connecting with the clients that you want to be connecting with? And otherwise, in other words, if you're fishing, are the fish that you're trying to catch in the lake that you're fishing in? Or are you fishing in a lake where there's no fish? And so what I mean by that is, if you're out there trying to catch clients in a situation where you're trying to, you know, onboard folks through Facebook ads or paid traffic or whatever to some kind of a website, you know, some sort of a generic, non-personalized experience where you just list all your skills, and you're trying to connect with local businesses like that, it's not going to work out. You're not going to be able to do that. So look at what you're doing and make a difference, you know, change the way that you're making that approach. And if it feels overwhelming and you don't know what to do, then that kind of leads into the next point, which is when you begin to identify where the rough spots are and the things that are generating these large scale problems, you know, like not having revenue to stay in business, not having the right clients, you know, those are very large problems. And when you overcome those serious problems, you're going to find that you have serious benefits from overcoming those challenges. But in order to do that, you have to touch the problem. You have to recognize what the issue is so that you can address it, but not becoming like paralyzed or overwhelmed by it. And so you don't want the problem to become your identity. Which is, you don't want to get to the point where you say, well, I just attract the wrong clients, or I don't have the right skill set for doing what you want to do, because that's not true either. Usually, almost all of the time, you can either ramp up your skill set so that you actually have better tools, or more times than not, it's simply the presentation of how you're going about doing it. Whether you're looking for clients in the wrong spot, using the wrong marketing techniques, putting a lot of energy and effort into things that don't produce results so you feel burnt out. And so those are problems that oftentimes people begin to embrace as their identity. Like, the problem is mine. Like, for whatever reason, you feel like I just don't have what it takes. And then that is really the recipe for quitting. Like, when you begin to feel like that, that means you're burnt out. That means you're about to quit, because no reasonable person would continue to burn themselves out, spend all of this energy, do all of these things, and continually not see the results that they're looking for. And so that problem becomes who you are. And then that leads to giving up. So in order to overcome that, so that you actually get through that, what you want to do is you want to touch the problem. You want to acknowledge that the issue is there, but you don't let the problem become an identity type thing. Like, it doesn't absorb you in a way that you can't resolve it. And so I don't know if you've ever tried to take like cold showers or sit in an ice bath or anything like that, but if you do, now I know this is kind of an extreme example, but it really illustrates the point very well. Like, the first time you do it, you're going to find that it takes your breath away, and like all you can think about is how cold it is and you can't stand it. But when you learn how to do that, like when you learn how to endure that sort of a stressful situation, what you find is you can feel the cold without becoming cold. And so what I mean by that is you feel that there's a situation that needs to be addressed. You feel that there's a problem there, but the problem doesn't overwhelm you. It doesn't freak your brain out. It doesn't paralyze you. It doesn't cause panic. And so that mindset allows you to overcome the challenges. And you know, the cold showers or the ice bath thing is just one tool that you might want to implement to train your mind to say that you are able to put yourself in a stressful situation without being overwhelmed by the stress. So you feel that it's there. You're not just like ignoring it and causing the problem never to go away or never to get better, or perhaps even fester and get worse. You're not doing that. But at the same time, you're not freaking out either. And so, and then when you take that mentality and apply that to your business, when you find, hey, you know, I'm not connecting with the right clients, or I'm not charging the right price points, or when I do try to charge more, then clients start rejecting me and I sort of hit this price ceiling. Those are big problems, but you don't want to say, hey, I'm just a low value consultant, I can't ever charge more. What you need to do is figure out how to fix the issue. And I can help you with that. That's a huge thing. That's like one of the main things that I can help you do is take the fullness of what you're able to do. Like the main thing, and the reason that I really wanted to start the DoubleStack program, and the reason that the clients that I'm working with are having so much success, is because it's a fundamentally challenging thing to do, especially on your own, to try to take the fullness of what you're capable of doing and apply that in a way that drives outcomes for your clients. Because most people tend to get caught up in the details of what they can do, and they focus on these individual details, oftentimes to the exclusion of some of their other skills. And consequently, you begin to compete against other people that just have, that maybe all they can do is just a sliver of what you can do, but you're comparing or competing your sliver against their whole selves, and consequently clients aren't able to discern the difference there in terms of the value. So for example, if you're good at building logos, but you're also a good photographer, you also can do videography, you also can do SEO, you also can build websites, you also have years of experience with branding and marketing, but somebody wants a logo, and then you compare that with someone else who's, you know, selling a logo for half the price of what you're doing, when you're comparing logos to logos, your client's gonna have a very difficult time discerning the difference. And the truth is, both logos would probably be fine. Like the quality of the logo usually has very little to do with how much revenue people are getting or how much money people are making. I mean, you can have a pretty bad logo and still have a pretty very successful business. You can have a fantastic logo. You can go and have the best logo there ever was and put, you know, Pepsi and Coca-Cola and Under Armour and Nike all to shame with your fantastic logo and never get a client. And so the point that I'm making is that, you know, when you take the fullness of what you can do, all of your experience, all of your skills, and you bottle that up into something that delivers results for your clients, that's really the key to success. And so what I'm talking about doing here is, like, I can help you identify those issues, but you have to be able to overcome the challenges that are in front of you so that you can actually reach out to clients at that level. And so kind of the next step along those lines is think through, like, what's not working and what does success actually look like? So as you're touching the problems and you're trying to kind of, you know, whittle it down to what actually is causing the issues and how you can overcome that stuff. The key is, what's the issue and what would it be like if you didn't have the issue? And what would the resolution of that issue be like? Like, what is the goal? Like, maybe you don't know the path from here to there. I can help you with the path, but what is the actual end goal? How do you want to get there? And what does that look like? Because when you can turn those big challenges into victories, what you end up having is these serious victories that you are able to overcome, and that makes a huge difference for your business. And the other thing is this. So now we've spent pretty much the whole time today talking about your business, your mindset, overcoming those challenges in a way that enables you to achieve massive success with regard to the things that are plaguing you, whether it's your pricing, whether it's your marketing, whether it's the types of clients that you're attracting. Maybe it's not attracting clients at all. You know, maybe it's you don't know how to connect your offline face-to-face interactions with any of your online tools, or you don't feel like you have the right tools. Whatever it might be, you know, there's a bunch of different problems that could be causing issues with regard to your pricing and growing your business and connecting with clients. But here's the thing, overcome those challenges and give yourself the kind of mindset where you're able to be the kind of person that has this ability to overcome serious challenges, and then take that mindset and apply it to your clients' businesses too, because they're going to be stuck in very similar types of problems. Not when I mean types of problems, I don't mean they don't know the technical tools or whatever. What I mean is they're going to have serious business problems in the same way that you might have serious business problems. But when you overcome yours and have the mindset and the character and the leadership and the confidence and the integrity that comes with being able to have that kind of six-figure mindset for your business, you can then take that level of power and apply that to your clients' businesses too and begin to overcome their challenges for them. And when that happens, that's the game. That's really the end goal at that point, because now you're not just selling them websites and logos and services and whatever. You're overcoming massive challenges for them, and you're powering those results with the types of things that you know how to do. And not just some of the things that you know how to do, but all of the things that you know how to do. And so that's a very important point. And this is one of the most important conversations we've really ever had in this group, because if you don't do this, you're never going to be able to make the business progress that you really want to be making if you're in the business of working directly with clients and using your technical skills to drive business outcomes for the people that you're working with. Now, if you're in the business of just wanting to be an awesome developer, then that's a different sort of a situation. So this conversation isn't really for people like that, because you can go and you can get a job at the government. Like, I've got plenty of college. I even had contracts like years ago. I used to work for the Virginia Department of Health doing bioterrorism surveillance, which was very data heavy job. And I got out of college, had a degree in computer science, went to work for the government. And it was back when, you know, anthrax was an issue and the avian bird flu was an issue. And I was analyzing the emergency records that would come through hospitals to see if there were any health anomalies in any of the emergency room visits. So, like, for example, if all of a sudden everybody in New York City was coming down with a respiratory ailment that was different from, you know, seasonally before, then that would be a red flag that, hey, perhaps there's some sort of an anthrax or some sort of a bioterrorism problem in that area. And so that was a lot of work, right? And it didn't really matter if I could overcome anybody's problems. What mattered for that kind of a job was, can I crunch the numbers? Can I do the work? Do I have the technical skills to pull it together? That's really that's the essence of that. So if you feel like what you really want to do, all you want to worry about are your technical skills, then go get a job at the government, at a large agency, at a corporation that where you can just focus exclusively on the technical side of things. And so, but if you're in the business where you want to have your own business, then you're going to find that you're faced with really serious challenges that are going to be difficult to overcome, because you just can't overcome them by looking up the answer on Google or in a book. You're going to have to search your mind for it. You're going to have to deal with your soul, because you're going to feel the weight of the issue, because you're going to have to fix this or you're going to not make a paycheck. You're not going to get paid. You're not going to get clients. And that's a huge differentiating factor compared to like learning just one more thing in order to be able to run a more efficient database query or something like that. So all that is to say that when you have the kind of mindset that enables you to build the business that you want, that's also the mindset that's going to attract the high value clients. And so that's a huge point to make. And so that the reason that you can charge 5 times and 10 times more than everyone else is because you solve problems that other people can't. Other people don't have the fortitude, the creativity. And then, the main thing that's behind the DoubleStack program is giving you 2 stacks. It's giving you this mindset that we're talking about, this business development consulting mindset that solves huge problems, and coupling that with the technical capability to actually do something about the problems. So it's one thing, like one of the things that was so frustrating for me about a year and a half ago was I would go to WordCamps and I'd give presentations similar to this or whatever, and people would come to me and be like, how can I do what you're talking about? And I didn't have anywhere to refer people, because I could either find one of 2 things, but I couldn't find both. I could either find somewhere to send folks to get better WordPress skills, plugin skills, PHP, JavaScript, CSS, technical skills, SEO. There's plenty of places to go and kind of build those types of skill sets, but those skills aren't really targeting business outcomes necessarily. They can be used for business outcomes, but they don't really have that focus. It's really just on the skill, learn how to do something new. Or I could send people over to like a business development kind of a place. Like, I had a couple of different places where I would refer folks to. And like, but the feedback, like, I literally just a couple of weeks ago, I was talking to a woman. She took a course on how to develop, basically like how to get leads from LinkedIn. And so I was like, hey, so was it a success for you? Like, did it work for you? And she said, sort of. And I said, what do you mean by sort of? And she said, well, I got plenty of leads. And I was like, oh, well, then that's a success, right? And she says, well, you know what? I didn't close any of them. I didn't get any clients. I just got leads. So I said, why? Why is that? Why? How can you get leads but no clients? And she said, well, nobody taught me what to do with the leads once I started talking to them. All I could do was I just had the shell of a business where I was generating leads from my LinkedIn work, but I couldn't close them into anything. I didn't have anything to do. And that's the symptom of only having the business stack, right? Because the business stack, you know, that's, you know, how do you get leads? The tech stack, though, is actually having something to do so that you can actually drive the results that your clients are counting on you for. You have to have both things. If you don't have both things, you can't make the kind of progress that we're talking about here, because you either know how to do a bunch of stuff, but you can't get clients, and you don't really have the business perspective on it, or you do have the business perspective, but you don't have the technical skills to put it all together. You have to have both areas of focus. That's the whole point of the Double Stack program. That's why it's called Double Stack. Those two stacks, the tech stack, the business development stack. So all that is to say, the reason that you can charge 5 to 10 times more than people that just have one of the stacks is because when you combine them both together, you're able to solve very deep and urgent problems for your clients that other people can't. And one of the main reasons they can't is a lot of people simply can't handle the mental side of the situation, where they don't want to be exposed to people that have these serious problems, or they can't overcome these types of problems for themselves. They don't have the grit, the fortitude. They see the problem, but they become the problem. Like, the problem overwhelms them like a wet blanket. But instead, what I'm suggesting that you learn how to do is kind of like with those ice baths or the cold showers. Feel the cold, but don't become cold. And when you do that, you give yourself the power to overcome serious obstacles, where you touch the problem, you analyze it without freaking out, and then you do something about it in a way that enables you to overcome that. And so, check this out here real quick. So the best way to solve problems is to work with somebody who can help out, right? So, like, the reason that your clients are hiring you is they have these urgent problems. You're coming along and helping them fix them, right? And so the best way for your clients to resolve the problems that you can help them with is for them to hire you to fix them, right? So, like for example, if you find yourself competing against low budget alternatives, whether it's, you know, people charging half of what you're charging or less, or maybe your clients are saying, well, you know, I could just go into Wix and build my own website or whatever. That's not solving the problem. Nobody has the problem of not having a logo. It's kind of like, I don't know if you've ever heard the kind of analogy, like, nobody has the problem where they need a quarter inch drill bit. Nobody needs a quarter inch drill bit. They need a quarter inch hole. And right? So that's the thing. They need the hole, not the drill bit, but they have to have the drill bit to get the hole. And so what I'm saying is, nobody needs the skills. And so if you come along and start offering individual technical skills to business owners, that's not going to help them break free from their problems. If they have deep, urgent problems, you and I both know they're not going to get the results they're looking for if they try to build their own website, because they don't have the experience and the skills necessary to do it. They can't just muster it up on their own. Likewise, if they try to hire someone else who's just in the process of trying to just crank out as many sites as they can, they're not going to get the kind of results that your client is not going to be getting the results that they really need from somebody who's not charging enough to be able to actually help at the level necessary. So, for example, one of the big things that I tell everybody in this group is you have to charge enough money so that you give yourself the opportunity to actually succeed, to actually deliver the results your clients need without having to piece things together and build in shortcuts and not really go all the way. And it's very unsatisfying as a developer to not be able to really do what's necessary. But what's even worse is it furthers the concept of just selling these bad investments. And of course, you know, and like we were talking about in the beginning, it's not your client's fault if they have the ability to recognize a bad investment. And that's why they're, you know, either not replying to your proposals or trying to whittle the price down or whatever. And so I think that we can all agree that if your client needs the type of results that you can deliver, they can't get it on their own. They have to hire you for it. And that's the same kind of situation that we're talking about right here. Like, if you feel like you're stuck and aren't able to attract the kind of clients that you want, you don't have the business structure that you want, you are struggling to get any kind of stability with your revenue coming in, and, you know, the prices are just not working out in such a way, because as soon as you put a price tag on something that's over $1,000, you get this massive resistance from your clients, and you don't really know how to overcome that, but yet you've got the mindset to do it. That's the real key. You have the mindset to want to fix the problem, and you've touched the problem, right? You've put your finger on, hey, you know, I think I've got some rough spots in these areas. The answer is to work with somebody who can help you fix the issue. In the same way that you would expect your client to hire you to fix problems that are outside of their reach, what I'm offering to do is help you get the kind of results that you want with your business by developing the mindset, developing the six-figure mindset, getting the tech tools in place that drive business outcomes, getting the business structure in place so that you can actually give yourself the opportunity to succeed because you're charging enough to do that, that you've got recurring revenue coming in so you don't have the feast or famine problem, so that you don't have to constantly spend non-billable hours trying to find clients and do all of this other stuff, and more of your time is on the billable side, which gives you more revenue, which means you have more freedom to do other stuff, so you're not overwhelmed working all day long every single day. Because if more of your time is billable hours, because you don't have to constantly search for clients, because you're working with the clients you already have on an ongoing basis, continuing to drive results, I think you can pretty quickly see how that's the kind of structure you really want to have in your business, because now you've got the money you need, you've got the stability you're looking for, and you're driving results for your clients, they're having the success that they want because their business is growing. It's just a win right on down the line compared to trying to just constantly fight for clients, low budget clients, doing all of this work that doesn't produce results, all of these types of things. And if you want the kind of help to kind of break out of that and get the technical tools that drive business results, the business structure that you need so they can really help your clients, then that's where I can come in and help you out with that. And the people that I'm working with are having tremendous success. I've been having success at this for 16 years. You know, they're having the kind of success where they're converting like $200 little like, can you fix the slider on my homepage clients into $10,000 per year contracts. And, you know, one guy that I've been working with over the past 6 weeks, he's closed $25,000 in new clients over the last 6 weeks because of making this kind of shift. If you've got the kind of mindset where you're solving serious problems for people, then that's the kind of results you can expect for, you know, for your business, because you're solving deep problems for other people, and that's a high ticket offer. Another guy that I'm working with, his very first client was like an $8,000 client. He never sold a professional website before. He had skills, he could do some things, but he was having a hard time connecting the dots there. And so in just a couple of weeks, he was able to land his first client. And of course, the main thing that I think is sometimes overlooked with regard to the DoubleStack program is it's not like an online course. What it is, it's you and me working together. And so the way that works is, like, if you feel like these are some of the things that you want to be addressing in your business, and you feel like we're kind of touching on some of the points that are kind of sticking points and obstacles for you to overcome, then the first thing to do is just give me a call and let's talk through it and just see where things are for free. So if you head over to doublestack.net/call, then you'll be able to find my schedule, get on it, we'll talk about this stuff for free, and we'll see what's going on. We'll see what's going on in your business. What kind of obstacles do you feel like are a big challenge for you? And, like, historically, where has the problem been? Like, let's put our finger on the different problems and let's see if that's something that we might be interested in working on together. If it's a good fit for you, if it's a good fit for me, we can talk about that too. If it's not, like, if you don't have to do the DoubleStack program if you talk to me. I'm offering to talk for free. If it sounds like the kind of thing where you want to continue working together after that, awesome. If not, that's totally cool too. But at least put yourself in a position where you're pointed in the right direction, right? So, like, if you constantly find that you're attracting cheap, low budget, you know, stressful clients, and like, isn't it always the case that the clients that are the cheapest are also the ones that want you to, like, to do the most stuff for free? Like, the highest stress, highest pressure clients are also the ones that are also the cheapest. If you find that that's the case for you, let's talk about how to fix that. How do you repoint the ship in a way so you're actually sailing into an area where you have access to better leads and better clients? And we can do that for free. We'll get on the phone for 45 minutes. We'll dive through your marketing, the way that you talk about yourself, the kind of skill sets that you have. Like, what makes you different? Like, do you have additional skills in addition to building WordPress sites that you might be able to leverage to drive better results for your clients? And are you using those skills to actually draw in the types of clients you want to work with? Or are you kind of just pushing those to the side because it's too difficult to figure out how to, you know, bring the entirety of what you know how to do to market? And so if those are some of the things that you're struggling with, let's get on the phone and get that sorted out for you. And then if it sounds like you want to work together, kind of implementing the stuff that we talk about, we can talk about that too. But the point is, head over to doublestack.net/call. And we'll get the ball rolling, get you pointed in the right direction. It's a free call. It's a little bit hard to find a time slot. I tried to open up my schedule as wide as I can, but again, it's going to be you and me talking. It's not like you and anybody else that works here. It's just you and me, and we'll figure this stuff out together. And that's going to be the key to overcoming the obstacles in your business, is to figure out, how do you do this in a way that not only can you implement the changes that we're talking about for you, but you can also then take that same mindset, the same tenacity that comes from overcoming serious obstacles, and applying that to how can you overcome serious obstacles that your clients are facing as well. And that, of course, is the key. That's the secret. You know, it's no secret here amongst us in this group, but everyone outside of the group, you know, those are the people out there just trying to crush it with technical services, selling websites, selling logos, selling graphic design work, selling whatever, responsive, whatever. You know, those types of things aren't solving serious, urgent problems for their clients. And a lot of times it's because they don't have the mindset to pull it off. Maybe they don't have the technical skills to pull it off. Maybe they don't have the business structure in place to make the right kinds of offers. So if you're here, what that means is you care about your clients, you care about your business, you care about integrity and leadership, you want to show up with confidence, you want to help your clients actually build a better business, you want to drive results for them that they wouldn't be able to get if it wasn't for you. And what I'm suggesting is, why don't we talk about how you can structure all of your skills in your business in a way that enable you to onboard clients at that level? And I think when you do, you're going to find that not only is your job more rewarding, it's also less stressful, it's easier to manage, and it's actually more valuable too. Like, in the event that you ever wanted to scale to the point where you were like selling your business, your business is infinitely more valuable if you have recurring revenue coming in than if you're just constantly hunting for clients all the time. So really, from start to finish, straight on down the line, when you make this fundamental shift from being like a person who just sells technical services to someone who actually is a business consultant who has the technical capability to pull off the recommendations, you're really coming to get to the table with the double stack. You're the guy that can do both things. You can help them solve these urgent problems in terms of the concepts, and you have the technical chops to actually implement the concepts that you're recommending. And if you need any help getting to the point where you're doing that, then let's get on the phone and get this happening for you. So head over to doublestack.net/call and you'll find my schedule there, and pick a time that works for you, and we'll get on the phone and get this happening. So awesome. So that's the idea today: overcoming serious challenges, having that six-figure mindset, how to develop it, how to put your finger on these problems, overcome them without being overwhelmed by them. And the benefit, of course, of if you do that, you're going to be the kind of person who can charge 5 to 10 times more than everybody else, because you've got what it takes to build a business for yourself, and you can turn around and use those exact same skills, that exact same mindset to really raise your clients up to a level that they wouldn't be able to get to if it wasn't for you. So again, if you want to talk about it, doublestack.net/call is the place to go for you and me to connect on this. And otherwise, you know, go ahead and leave a comment, and I'll be keeping an eye on that here. If you're checking this out on any of the podcasts, whether it's on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Spotify, and you want to be part of these conversations where you can ask questions and kind of interact real time, head on over to the Facebook group at Building High Value WordPress Sites. It's a Facebook group. It's free to join, and you can, you know, be part of these sessions. If you're checking this out in Facebook and you want to kind of get these lessons on the go, you can subscribe to and review, if you would, the podcast, which is, again, it's on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify. If you go to doublestack.net, slide down to the footer, you'll see links to be able to connect in to all of those different sources for the podcast. And if you could, please leave a 5-star review. That would be awesome. Boop, high five for you. And looking forward to connecting with you guys next Tuesday. We do these once a week on Tuesdays, and occasionally on a Thursday. If possible, we get together for another session as well. But the idea here is Tuesdays at 2, training sessions for you. All right, guys. Boop, another high five for you. And look forward to connecting with you guys next week. Awesome. Take care and have a great week.